Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Fishing Rod. It's 2014, which means we have a huge sockeye salmon return to the Fraser River. So the estimated return is about 25 million fish. We're fishing in early September now, which is towards the end of the season. That doesn't mean the fishing is not going to be good, but in fact it's going to be really good because we're fishing for the late summer run, which is estimated to be around 12 million fish. We're fishing at the Fraser River mouth today with Bon Chovy Fishing Charters. So Jason, hopefully he's going to be getting us into some fish. This late summer runs typically are pretty big. The fish are the biggest. Those are the Adams River salmon.
Yeah, primarily,
right?
Yeah. The fish that show up in late August, early September, primarily.
Yeah, so they're roughly around, 6 pound, 8 pound?
Yeah.
Sometimes bigger. Yeah. And what do they hold around here?
They usually hold for a couple weeks just to get acclimatized to the freshwater environment. The late run fish typically will come in and they'll hold for like 6 to 14 days or something.
Right.
And
right.
In the last few days in Johnston Straits, the numbers have really died off, but that doesn't mean the fishing is not going to be good here because the fish that came through last week are just getting here now, and hopefully they'll stage here for the next 10 days or so.
And notice that as we come along, you were looking for fish everywhere, right? We were looking for risers and kind of spotting fish. Is that pretty important?
Exactly, yeah. Look for floppers and watch your sounder
and
stuff,
because
sockeye are in huge schools. So, I mean, if you're not seeing them on your sounder, chances are they're not there.
You're getting fish, yeah. Are we running dummy flashes on the downriggers as well?
Yeah. Right now we're running fairly deep. We're running two mainline flashers with red Michael Bait hoochies, and then below that we're running three dummy flashers as well.
Oh, yeah. So why so many flashes?
The idea is that we're trying to actually build a school behind our boat. So if a sockeye sees another sockeye or a flasher, the idea is that he'll follow that, and then another one will follow, and then another one will follow. And sometimes you can just build your own school behind the boat. And if you have fish behind the boat, sometimes you get lucky, right?
And this fish is very tide dependent, I guess?
Tide dependent, yeah. Sockeye, like when they're actually off the Fraser here, they're not feeding, they're just biting out of instinct. And the nice thing here is they're just in such volume. So even if there's a school of, say, 5,000 fish, you only need three or four to bite every 10 minutes or something, if possible.
Yeah.
But once they kind of reach the straits or wherever else in the inside here, they're not feeding. They're just biting out of instinct. They primarily feed on krill and euphausids offshore, I guess.
Right.
And that's why we use those little pink hoochies.
Right. And you were saying when the tide's really moving really fast, that tends to be kind of like a slow time.
It can be, yeah.
Yeah, so we're getting down to the tide change pretty soon, right?
Yeah.
So that's what you're hoping for?
We're hoping, yeah. Right now we're kind of mid-ebb, and then the tide's going to start flooding at about 12:30 or 1. I think it's about 10:30 now, so it may be slow here for a couple hours, but as the tide kind of settles, hopefully we'll see some larger schools, and we should see them start to jump and stuff. We're seeing the odd one here, if you look out in the distance. We're seeing one every few minutes, but when the tide settles, ideally they'll be jumping every 10 seconds everywhere. So
So you promising fish, I guess?
No, I'm not promising. We're just going to have to wait and see. Every day is different, and sometimes waves of fish will go in the river, and that's just how it is. Every day is different, but the last few days have been pretty good, so.
Excellent. Well, fingers crossed. We're just going to wait for the tide change and let you set up the other rods.
Sounds good.
Okay, let's go.
Thank you.
we're 15 minutes into the fishing now, and it's been pretty fast. So the first fish came after 5 minutes, which was a Chinook salmon, kind of a surprising bycatch. And the second fish came 10 minutes later. Well, not even that, actually. It was a sockeye salmon, a small sockeye salmon that Nina got. So there's quite a few fish rising around, just jumping everywhere. So we're hoping the bite is coming on and just waiting for the next one. I'm going to grab the next one. So,
oh, there's one.
There's one. There you go. Oh, he's gone, I think.
It's off?
Yeah. I think he's gone.
Yeah, it was barely touching it, though.
Like, just before you grabbed it, looks like he just kind of
Yeah, just kind of stopped, yeah.
But yeah, like, right on the turn, eh?
So we're just seeing a pretty big school of fish going by on the sounder, and showing up, we got one bite of it, but I missed it.
Oh. He's gone.
He's gone? Oops, sorry.
It's all good. We'll just try different angles at this school, but
I guess we'll come back again because it's still in the rigger, right?
Yeah, it should be okay. They just grabbed it once, but it's pretty neat. You just change the angle and then you kind of get them to bite at times. There it is. There you go. Go. Hit it again. It's still in the clip.
Oh, it's still in the clip.
Reel. There you go. I'm just going to clear this one because we're on the turn. Still got him?
Yeah, still got it.
Your drag's probably still pretty tight, so if you have a second, just knock her back a bit.
Right.
That rod got hit 3 times in a minute.
Yeah. Oh, do I still have it?
Yeah, he's still there.
He's still there? It's always hard to tell.
There you go. And then if you can choose one side of the downrigger, take one step back.
Yep.
Just walk him around the rigger.
All right.
Oh, no. Oh, ah, there.
Yep.
There you go.
There you go.
Nice.
Another
a little
one.
Bigger, this one?
This one's a little bigger.
Oh, there's a hole in the net.
Oh, no.
Note to self.
It's a catch and release net, isn't it? Oh, it's good. So we saw a pretty big school going by on the sounder. And what Jason did was we turned the boat, just hoping that we'll get some reaction out of it. And sure enough, we missed one. Well, I missed one. I missed another one over here. And it came back on the same rod again. And here we have. We got one fish in the net.
There's a fish. Get a rod again.
Go. He popped the clip already. Just start reeling. Nice and easy now, and do your drag. I'm just gonna clear this side. Does he clear the other one? I think he got him.
Yeah, I got him.
Is your drag all clear? Ah, he's tangled there a little bit. He's got a little bit of a tangle there, but. Just go nice and easy on these guys. May have come off on that tangle, but he might still be there. He's still there. We got a bit of a tangle. Hey, oh, he's got a lamprey on him too. And we got a bit of a nightmare there. Let me take one step back. I'll see if I can sort that out. Oops. Okay. Sorry, guys. Oh. And then just walk to the other side there. Sorry, Shane. Motor. Okay, take one step back. That's a nice one. He made us work for it.
So what, this sockeye number 3? Not a bad one. It's made us work for it a bit. Came back and then we had a bit of a tangle. But nice and slimy. Nice silver one. And into the bucket she goes.
go, go, reel, 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 keep reeling, keep reeling. There you go, grab the rod now. And reel and do your drag too if you can. That was on the turn, so I'm gonna have to clear this line again.
All right, I forgot.
Okay.
It's a little heavier than the other one.
Your first one was a midget. Oh, it's a darker one, that one. Just take one step back, Ina. And then we're gonna try and get him on this side here. See, Shane, if I can catch you that.
Yeah, I'm trying. Well, if it's too dark, do you wanna keep him?
Ah, it's up to you guys. We'll just see what he looks like, I guess, eh? And just be aware of this downrigger here.
Yeah.
So sockeye are typically pretty easy to steer. That's a big male.
You want him right here?
You can just reel a couple more times. You got one too?
Double head.
Double. Oh, go. Someone grab that rod. Somebody grab it. Nina, go. Oh, he's still on there. He popped the clip. You got that one too? Yeah, he's still there.
I still got him.
This is what you call a triple, I guess, eh? That's the wrong net. Okay.
Okay, what? What's going on here?
You okay? Is there one there too? Oh, you're tangled with the other one, Nina, so I'm gonna have to pop that other one.
Oh, okay, that kind of.
Oh, he came off. Okay.
Oh, yeah, right. I think he's still on. I think mine's still on. Woo! That's exciting.
Okay. Did you do your drag at all?
No, I didn't.
Let's just knock it back there a little bit.
I did.
And this one?
But that was a different fish.
Oh, was it? Good. This is my second one now. Third one.
Oh, he's right there. Okay. You can take one step back, Nina. And we'll try and get him just in front of this downrigger. Hey, Shane, can you grab this rod?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a nice one there. Okay, take a few more turns on her. And walk back. There you go. Over.
Woo.
Oh. Nice
one.
That's
a bigger one, yeah.
Yeah, the first ones we got were females. Now we're getting some males.
Wow. I didn't even get to see the second one. I was on to the third one. Oh, please stay.
What's been happening?
Well, we had one bite. I got him, hooked him. And while we were bringing him in, another bite, and Shane took that rod. And then a third bite, and I ran for that one while we were bringing the first one. That's almost too much excitement.
This. Okay,
so we got
buddy.
Two of them out of three. That's not bad.
That was a boat.
Well, we got a big school behind us right now, so we're just hoping for some more bites. I think we have, how many do we have? Four?
Fish. Keep reeling. It'll pop. There you go. Nice angle too, because it's on the turning. You want to clear that outside rod chain?
This
well, it was
heavy.
On a turn, so it'll likely tangle just because it was the inside rod, but you might be okay. You know what? She's fine, actually. Oh, double. Okay, I'll grab it.
And now we got a double. Yay.
I think you lost it. Oh, I lost mine. You still got yours.
Yeah.
That was a good one. Yeah, we got enough fish anyway. All right, take one step to your left there, Nina. Nice size on that one.
Yeah, he feels heavier.
Okay, reel a couple more times. And rod up high. No! Oops.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Okay, stay right on the rail here, just because just so you can always see your fish until the last minute there. Okay, reel a bit. We got a big lamprey on him.
Oh, cool. I want to see that lamprey.
I think the lamprey fell off.
Oh, there we go.
The lamprey still there? And the lamprey fell off. It's fish, it's fish. Still on the clip, you got it. Oh. It's on the turn, so it's a there you go.
Fish number, hopefully we get it in. Doesn't feel too big. Oh, not too bad. Oh, shoot.
You lose him?
Yeah. Looks like I saw Rodney's camera and just got camera shy and took off and spat the hook.
There, another one, another one, another one, another one. You got him.
Time for redemption. Hopefully he doesn't see Rodney.
Can you steer him that way if you can there, Shane? If he's able, or if you're able.
Uh-oh.
Sorry, bud. You okay?
Yeah. This one's really colored.
Yeah, a little bit. Oh, watch the motor.
Popped up for 1 second.
Where's he going?
Oh, he wants to go that way.
You bring him over there. I don't know if you can.
I'm gonna try to get it this way.
You want
to
all go back here? Okay. That's a nice one.
Oh no! Came up again. That's another one. That was a nice one.
That was nice and clean. That
yeah,
one.
Yeah, that was quite big as well.
Reel. Still in the clip, there you go.
I think it's gone. Shall see. Maybe it's still there. Yeah, it's still there.
Still there. Yeah. Not really much of a fighter.
No.
Pretty one step back.
Oh, actually.
That's a nice chrome one there.
Oh, don't jump off. Oh. Lost another one.
There he is.
He's still back there. Laughing at me.
Oh, there he is again.
I lost a bunch of fish.
Want to take one step back?
And hopefully I can get this one in.
Now he wants to go on the other side of the boat.
Should I take him on the other side?
No, you can. We'll just turn the boat here. Sorry, guys. See if you can turn him. Oh! Another one, another one!
middle, or he's gone.
He was there.
Just walk him in.
Rod up. Oh no! I almost had him there too.
No comment. Cut. Cut.
Oh, you tangled.
Did you tangle up?
I think so. I guess it's on this one here, so just hold up for one.
Okay, yep.
Yeah, if you could just at the same speed as Rodney.
Yeah. Shane lost quite a few, so I decided to take over the rod and see if he can land one.
Oh, he's still there and he's not tangled.
These fish are making us work a little bit.
Okay, coming in. All right, excuse me.
He's grabbing the net. Here we go. Oh. Oh, jeez. Oh my god. Oh. Really? When I start shaking their head on the surface, it came right off. Yeah, I couldn't breathe, eh? What did we do wrong? Lots of hooking, just not landing.
They're not making it.
It's gonna go over here.
Go to the other side now.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yep.
Uh-oh. Oh, jeez.
Oh, it's a nice one too. Yeah. Can you walk him around?
Yeah, I can.
Okay,
just go underneath.
And walk in for that rig.
Okay, yeah.
I can feel these coming in.
We've got quite a bit of tangle over here while fighting that fish. When you have that much terminal tackle in the water, it's going to happen from time to time. That's part of the reason why we have more challenges landing these fish. Tackle.
Oh, you're hooked up.
It's on your shirt. So that was my fourth one landed. And I was just waiting for Shane to land one more fish, and then we're done for the day. Here you go. Nice sockeye salmon. Another big late summer run. Beautiful fish.
I'm even gonna turn the rigger in. You just walk around everything there.
There you go. Took a little while.
Nice fish.
And a nice fish too.
That was a pretty good trip.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah, pretty productive.
Yeah.
Lots of bites.
Lots of bites.
Probably 20 or so hookups.
Yeah, somewhere in there for sure. Or if not more, actually, because we got 12.
Yeah, that's right.
Probably 12, a lot. Anyways.
12 landed and maybe lost another 12.
Yeah,
something
somewhere
like
in there.
That. Yeah, took a while to get our limit at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I guess this time of year, for the peak sockeye season, that's what you can expect, right? You come out and do pretty well.
Usually, I mean, we have our odd slow day because fish move, obviously, but, you know, sockeye, they're just in such huge numbers in peak years like this year, and it's usually pretty consistent.
Right, you know? Right. Yeah. So let's talk about a little bit about the tackle that we used. It's pretty simple from what I can see. It's pretty simple trolling setup.
Yep.
Got your Islander reel, MR2s, and what these are conversions.
Medium heavies, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. But solid rods.
These are pretty heavy rods. Are they? Because you're catching Chinook salmon as well.
Yeah.
You actually got one Chinook.
Yeah, they're. We did. Yes. A good multi-purpose rod.
Right. So just know. In case you get a really big Chinook, you can actually handle it. And the flashers.
The flashers are Gibbs Delta, and these are the Guide Series flashers. This one's actually called the Bon Chovy.
Yeah.
And it's just a chartreuse blade with some UV tape.
Right.
And it's been really good for the last year anyway.
Yeah. So
since it came out.
And like we said, besides these one here, we also run dummy flashers.
Dummy flashers, yeah.
The downriggers, just so we can, lots of flash in the water, because the water is quite dirty, so we can actually attract the fish right into the oil area and bite it, right? So what do we use on the hook?
Those are our Michael Bait Hoochies. I think they're made by Yamashita.
Right.
And they're basically the only thing that sockeye bite with any consistency.
Right.
You know, you'll get the odd one on a spoon or...
Right.
Or a piece of bait, but for the most part, I mean, pink hoochies, I mean, that's what sockeye bite with consistency.
Yeah. Any reason for that?
Maybe in their ocean environment, when they're offshore, they feed on a lot of krill, so maybe it's the right color. I mean, here, they're not really feeding. I mean, every sockeye we clean today will have nothing in their stomach, so they're just biting out of...
Just out of instinct kind of thing?
Instinct. Yeah.
Yeah, great. Excellent. And the hooks, what size is that?
It's a 5-up barbless. I think that's either an owner or a gammy.
Right.
Sockeye have really soft mouths, so it's really important to have a really sharp hook. If your hook's cheap or if it's dull, I mean, you're just kind of wasting your time. Just because sockeye, as you saw today, just are so finicky.
Yeah, just wanna make sure. End, we're just losing every fish. As soon as they come to the surface and start doing the shape, they pop right off so easily, right?
Yeah. If you're spending all the money on gas or whatever else, you want to make sure that you have a good sharp hook. I mean, it's
so
key.
Excellent, yeah. So how long is this fishing good until?
Tough to say. I mean, right now it's September 9th, I think.
Yeah. It's another 1.5 week, I guess.
Somewhere in there. In 2010, it was open until I think the 20th or the 21st, and there was fish all the way to the end.
Right.
But I would imagine they're going to shut it down by, and as you were saying earlier, between the 15th and the 20th.
Right.
So we should be in solid shape for the next week, but tough to say.
Yeah, and most likely we can expect the same thing again next year, right? It's a smaller run, but most likely there will be a fishery again next year.
Yeah.
As well.
Yeah, in 2011, it was pretty good. I think there's 6 or 8 million fish came back.
Yeah.
But they were, I think, primarily summer. So next year we should see them kind of mid-August to early September, somewhere in there.
Yeah, so if you want to come out and try it out, you can go to Jason's website at bonchovy.com, and then they can also always call you as well, right?
Yeah, they can call or email.
Email and check the website for details for the openings and stuff. And but again, thanks very much for taking us out, getting all the fish.
Yeah.
Yeah, pleasure.
Pleasure as always.
Hey everyone, I hope that you have really enjoyed this special feature on the Fraser River sockeye fishery. Many thanks to our sponsor Gibbs Delta Tackle for making this feature possible. For more information on their freshwater and saltwater fishing tackle, please check out their website at gibbsdelta.com. And many thanks once again to Jason at Bon Chovy Fishing Charters. Jason and his guys does year-round saltwater salmon fishing around Vancouver, as well as crabbing and prawning. So if you've ever visited this beautiful city, be sure to check them out at bonchovy.com. For more fishing information in British Columbia, please check out our website at fishingwithrod.com. And make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, there are always new videos coming out. And if you have any questions regarding this fishery or any other fisheries in British Columbia, you're always welcome to leave a comment or send us an email at info@fishingwithrod.com. And I'm always happy to help you out. Until next time, good luck fishing.